His mission started as a peasant, his class was low in the dirt. He tried to work, but no one could see what he was worth. Transparent to the parents that had given him birth. His life only got worse, but he never saw it as a curse. He only saw it as an obstacle. Nothing's impossible, improbable, maybe. Is it crazy to say that it's optional? Logical mind is sought to use it to his advantage. All alone, stranded in the land he was handed. He woke up from a dream and with this land he commanded. And since then, it seemed that his plan had expanded. But he's been dwelling on these plans for centuries. A descent from the king, so it was only meant to be. Banished from the palace when he was a young prince. Ever since he displayed artistic talent, they were convinced he had imprints of evil. If even just a glint of him was enough to stray, lead him in a sprint. Chased from his castle by nobles flaming torches. Now he has dreams of piles of nobles flaming corpses. Now he is remorseless, his hatred reinforces. His gathering damaging weapons compiled up in his forges. His force is unstoppable, his strength is optimal. His mental optical is as sharp as humanly possible. Thinking about the times he looked through his blood to his goal. Beat half to death, his masters kept hugging his soul. Crushing his whole frame, but his brain stayed tough in his skull. Brushing the old memories off like dust and he goes. To his destiny ready, expecting the rough overflow of bottled emotions that he sure enough doesn't show. He snuck in his old palace by snapping a guard's neck. Violent but silent, compiling images of prospects. He ran down the main hall, splitting bodies in half. Met eyes with his old brother and disembodied his ass. He saw his old nurse, she tried to help him at first. But when worse came to worse, she was the first one to curse his existence. So he split her open, smooth like incisions. And he hanged her by her organs to form his mental visions. His mission is only a short distance away. Consistently resisted, never listened, always disobeyed. His father, he thought that this would be no different. But taking your father's throne takes more than resistance. He opened the doors where most men would bow. But he stands proud, arrived at his destiny now. Battle of the century, so it's meant to be loud. But incidentally, he simply felt mentally clouded. And his father shrouded in luxurious curtains, causing shadows emerging in the shape of a serpent. Certain demise is possible, it's wise to think of strategies beforehand, not to die. But he realized he needs more than to strategize, cause his father's sword manship is more than precise. The king rose from curtains, holding his wife at ransom. He said, "I'll murder your mother if you continue advancing." Glancing in his eyes, straight looking at the fury, the king realized that he'd rather face a jury. He'd rather be executed than attacked by his son. The thought of his child taking his place of number one, it made him nauseous. The king knew he had to be cautious. He'd grown weaker and weaker after all of his losses. But the young warrior, he wasn't aware. He thought the king would kill his mother in the blink between stares. Beware, he declared, right there he no longer cared. A man prepared to wear a bloodstained crown in his hair. He threw his sword at his mother and chopped off his father's hand, ready to wreak havoc on the king that he cannot withstand. Honest man, he went crazy, vision hazy. Killed his mother like she was any ordinary lady. Stole his father's sword and beheaded her in one swing, to get rid of the one thing between him and his number one dream. His father was disarmed, begging on his knees and arms, in the fetal position, screaming, "Please cause me no harm." The young man stood with one sword in each hand, one holding the head of his beheaded mother through her teeth, and the other one aimed at such a fucking weak man, ready to tear apart any bands to his weak clan. He scalped his father and put the crown on his dome. Stepped over his parents' cadavers and he sat on his throne.
Ah, the fascination of war. Some men can't kill, others don't mind. But for Buddy, it's as necessary as breathing. I wouldn't give him any excuse.